Hello there, welcome back to my channel for another interesting episode about one more algae type, that is the blue-green algae, which is there in this aquarium, but you know you can't see it in this angle, but I'll show you that, you know, up close in a moment. So with that clear, let us actually begin the video. So to begin with, I can actually identify four different types of algae in here, and I think it's some sort of like the algae conference happening in this aquarium. But if I was actually a beginner and this happened to me, I would have just, you know, literally took this aquarium apart and then reset it from the start. But as of now, my experience dealing with algae, making aquariums increase, I'm actually quite sure that I can revive this tank to its old glory, and that's what I'm going to be showing you in this video. I'll show you all the types of algae up close in a moment, but before that, let me actually tell you how all this happened so that we can rectify each of our mistakes and then start cleaning the tank. I was away for actually a period of 10 days. And during that time, the light and the CO2 were in automation and the fertilizers were being dosed by my mother. So what happened was that as soon as I left, I don't know, maybe within 1 or 2 days, the CO2 diffuser broke, leading to fluctuation. Sorry, it cannot be called as fluctuation. Total or complete absence of CO2 in this tank. So that really messed up the balance in this ecosystem. And that's why all these things happened. And if you remember in the last video about this aquarium, I told you this is running at 30 degrees Celsius. So it's like, like the snap of a finger by Thanos. Things changed drastically in a tank like this, which is running at 30 degrees Celsius. But on the other hand, if you have an aquarium which is at 22 or 24 degrees Celsius, things don't get messed up this much too soon. But because of the temperature, everything got messed up very fast. So now let's actually take a closer look and let me show you what are the other types of algae in this tank so that you can identify them, and I'll explain to you what the causes of this blue-green algae or cyanobacteria is after that. Now let me show you the four different types of algae in this tank. The first one is this one, which is a green patch which you can find here. This is the green dust algae. And the second one is like a brownish patch. Okay, it's not that much easily visible. If you can see this green, if you can see the brown patch here, which is on this side of the glass, that is actually diatoms. So I've already made a video of the green dust algae and diatoms in my channel. If you want to watch that, you can check the link in the description where I've given it. Now coming to the next one, that is this one over here, which is a bit different from this in color. If you can observe, it's kind of a blue green color, and if you see this side, you can clearly make it out. That is, see, this is the blue green and this is the light green. This is the green dust algae, and this are the cyanobacteria or the blue green algae. And the next one is something behind the glass. That is, if you can observe that, there is a piece of rock there and there is bubbling happening in that rock, and that is nothing but the BBA or the black brush or the black beard algae. Once I clean the glass, you'll be able to identify them. Now I'll actually leave a list of causes or the general causes of algae on screen right now. You can actually pause the video and take a note of it. And as said in this video, that I'm going to be talking about this one, that it's a blue-green or the blue-green algae or the cyanobacteria. I leave the main causes for them to appear in a tank as well on screen. So pause the video and take a note of that as well. And then we'll be rectifying all the problems one by one, which I'll be showing you after this demonstration. So if you can see here, we have a huge amount of excess organic waste collected in the substrate. There is lack of flow, and the the CO2 is given in a higher concentration, leading to lack of oxygen. And then if you see, there is surface evaporation, wherein the flow pattern, the uniform flow provided by the filter changes, and it will directly fall down, where it will be obstructed by the rocks in this tank. And if you check the back side, you can see there is a huge mass of plants. That is, this is a Rotala macrandra pink, and these are the main things that should be cleared as of now. So now let me, okay, one more thing is, after the regular maintenance, you need to add two more things in this tank, which will help in preventing the appearance of this cyanobacteria and also replenishing the healthy beneficial bacteria in your tank. And that is nothing but these two, phytonjit plus and green bacter plus. Both these should be dosed daily at night. So with that clear, now let me keep the camera on a tripod and start the cleaning. So that was the primary protocol to be followed regarding dealing with any kind of algae. And now you can see these stones, they are completely infested by the BBA, or the black beard or the black brush algae, and there are some on these plants as well. And regarding the cyanobacteria, they are not totally gone. You can see some are there on this rock, and some are there on these plants as well. And we have actually lost some of our HC cuba, but they seem like they're floating right now. Don't actually try to go inside and push them back into the soil, because you'll end up with a lot of them floating in the water surface. Now we have actually corrected the filter flow. We have a good flow from this side to this side, thereby ensuring good amount of water circulation. And see, there is BBA in there as well. Let me zoom in and show you. Yeah, that's the one. And again, see how heavily infested is this rock with the BBA here as well and here. And let me show you how this stone actually looked before. See the color and see the difference. This is the BBA and this is the original color of these stones. See this color, it's almost kind of a brick red or orange in color. So there's a lot more to be done regarding the regular maintenance. I need to maybe do water changes maybe once or like thrice in a week, and then keep on dosing this one, that is the phytongite plus and green bacter plus, at night. Please make a note, it should be dosed only at night. And yeah, I think that about covers it up. And in the next episode, I'll show you how to actually get rid of the BBA. So I think that about covers this video. With that complete, this is your Nature Request signing off. Bye bye.